Welcome to the Beyond the Press channel.
Hello!
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And today we have video where we take something small and make giant version of it. And the thing that we are supersizing is meter. It's wireless meat thermometer. So it's idea to use this when you cook like big clump of meat in your oven or grill or pan. And this is mostly steel, and then there is, I think this is some kind of ceramic and more steel, or like, so it can be in the oven and not melt. And we have already made the supersized version. I'm going to show it now, and then we show how we made it. So this is 125 millimeters long, so a bit over 10 centimeters. And this is 1 meter long. And as you can see, it has all the same features. It has the steel here, and this is unfortunately plastic. I 3D printed this, and then more steel here. And it has a couple of secret features that we are not going to show yet. So here's the giant one, and here's the small one. And out of all new Bluetooth things, this is one of the best. I think there is like real purpose of this, because the wireless things, they are always close to the oven and you drop them and stuff like that. So my main problem with the old fashioned thermometers is that I destroyed them. They last like 1 year, and because of this goes inside of that big one and it's held with one screw there, I already almost destroyed this one because I over-tightened the screw because I forgot that this isn't solid metal. But it still works even with like dent like this, so I think this is quite like, I'm not going to destroy this. And this has clever mobile phone app that allows you to manage the cooking. Yep, so here is the app and here's the meter, and it turns on when you just remove it from the charging station, and now you can stick to it into your meat that you are cooking. And then you can choose from the meter what you are going to cook. You don't even have to know how to read. You just choose what animal you have killed. For example, that kind of looking. And then which part of animal you are cooking. Let's take steak. And then how do you want it, like rare, medium, and it says that these are like at least safe choose, you don't going to be sick, but I take some risk, so I choose medium rare, and then starts cook, and it shows that how you should install it there on the first time. We're not going to be interested on that. And then it shows how it's going to be cooked. I hold it now in my hand, so it starts to get warmer, and then you have also like chart, there is your target and there is current situation. So pretty simple and easy to use, and there is also some like benefits compared to just knowing the current temperature. And it all, of course, it's like alarms when it's ready. And now it's operating with Bluetooth, but there is like also cloud thing where you can like be away from your home and it still works. Yeah, but now I show how we made the giant one. And the first part was to make 3D model of big thermometer, and I did this mainly for this 3D printed part. I didn't model the threads or any features on this part because they are quite simple, and it's just faster to do them on the lathe out of my head. When you are designing and making the parts yourself, you can take shortcuts like this. If somebody else is going to machine this, then I of course would have to model the threads and everything here. It's also pretty easy, but now since I'm doing this myself, there is no need. And I think I show this part's features on the 3D printer software. It's a bit easier there. So here it is on my 3D printer software, and this cube here is the volume of the printer. So it's quite tall piece, and since it's really tall and quite narrow, it's important to be sure that it's attached well on the table, because it's quite long lever when the printer is moving here. So you have to be sure that it's not going to come loose. So this is the head of the thermometer, the square shaped one. And there is hole for the steel part to attach. And usually if you have big hole like this, you would need support material here. But it's quite hard to get rid of. So I made like cone shaped ending for the hole. So I don't need any support material, and it's much easier to work like this. You don't need to do anything for the piece after it came out from the printer. And then there is some solid stuff, and then there is hole for the rest of the meter to attach. Yep, and then we just transfer everything to the printer and continue from there. Yep, and here I have 3D printer now going on, and it has been doing like maybe 10 minutes now, and still pretty long way to go. The program says that it's going to take 12 hours, and it's that long because I have only 0.15 millimeter layers. I decided to go quite fine quality because I don't have anything else to print, and I'm going to send the parts in 3 days, so it doesn't matter how long it takes. I'm also using quite slow speed because the part is quite narrow, and I'm a bit worried that it may come loose. Now we have both sides like almost ready, and we are going to do the thread between of these two. So this is going to be like screw, and this is going to be like nut, and then you can like, and then it's together. And we could do boring regular threads there, like some precise millimeter reading, like M50 times 1 or something like that. But I have always been wanted to do my own thread, just like some crazy random numbers. And if I do that, then nobody knows what is the thread, and nobody can do like spare parts for the machine where I use my own thread. And this has been my long dream. And now we are going to make world first Anni thread. So I think we are going to mix up with the millimeters and inches, and do some completely random numbers, and then nobody but all the viewers will know what is my thread. And if somebody is going to try in future to make, for example, this pointy stuff on the front and attach it here, it's going to be really hard because they have no idea of my Anni thread. Yeah, we have quite limited amount of steel to work here. So we are not going to be able to go completely crazy, but I think we can do something stupid with the dimensions of the thread. Yep, and here is our current situation. The wall thickness on the pipe is only about 5 millimeters, and we are going to divide that like this, that we are going to have about 2 millimeters steel here, then about 1 millimeter of thread there, and then 2 millimeters steel there. There, so then it should be quite tough. And to make it that's like really confusing Anitred. I came up with clever solution. So here we have the bits that we can use. So here we have millimeter dimensions, and here we have inch dimensions. But because I'm too lazy, I'm not interested in calculating these to millimeters. I'm going to use these. So there we have 1 millimeter, quite reasonable, and 1.25, pretty good also. But these two empty lines, these are just some completely random stuff. And I think we are going to pick, yep, and to make this Anitred, let's give Anni to make the decision. Are we going to use this 2 or 3?
2.
Yep, so it's some mystery number between 1 and 1.25. And there would be no reason to use this in like real work. Nobody would ever guess that it's like this. I think if somebody tries to fix something that has thread like this, they would think that the thread is damaged in some way, and there would be no way, or then they would think that it's some really weird inch thread. Nobody in the world would guess that we are going to use something like this. So let's make that. Yep, so now we are ready for the thread. It's going to be here. And because we are doing it with manual lathe, we have to have like area where we stop the machine. And it's going to be this area here. So we are going to go from here and then stop here, pull out, go here and again. And then this area here, this is slightly larger than this. And the idea is to line the pieces with this, so this is going to have like really tight width, like only 0.05 millimeter gap between this and the part that goes over this. And then this outer dimension is going to be lined really well with the next part, and it's going to look good. And we could do like really precise thread, but it's really hard, especially when you are doing that stupid thread. So it's better idea to leave like couple tents here loose with the thread, and then use this to line the things up. So let's change the threading tool here and then do this. And making threads with manual lathe, it's a bit like advanced task. You should first check the feed that you have thread chosen there, and then you look from the chart what are the settings for the rest of the levers. And I have them set up now for this thread. And then you take threading tool. You have to have right tool. This is millimeter tool, so it has right shape for millimeter thread, metric thread here. And then you put this here. And then you have to put the sled also to threading mode, which is there. And now you cannot move it from here at all. But when you start the machine, it will go quite fast. And now, per one revolution, we are going to be that mystery number, which is one bit over 1 millimeter forward on every turn. And yeah, now we just wait that we get there, on top of the area where the thread is going to be. And I'm going to touch it very slightly with the tool. Like this. And then I'm going to zero it there. And now because we are not going to know what is the pitch, we have to use my clever trick, which is to go in as long as it takes to make it look good. Yeah, so, and you cannot take too much at one go, like maybe 3 tenths, and you have to use some oil to get good shape. So let's go back. And then in, let's take 3 tenths. I put some this there. And here we go.
Ooh. Oh my.
Yep.
Whoa.
So this is like
whoa.
Started now, and we have still plenty to go. As you can see, there is only like really shallow groove, and we need to take more. So I back up. Kuvasta koko ajan tuota. And on the beginning, you are not removing much, so you can take more. And when you get deeper and deeper, you can take less and less. So I think we are going to take the same amount as on the first go. Yep.
Whoa.
Still plenty to go. Now I take a bit less. So now the grooves are 0.08 deep, so we have maybe 0.3 millimeters still to go, so let's take more away. I put it on 1 millimeter. Yep, so we should be almost done. I think I take, now it's 0.5 millimeter deep, and because it's some mystery number over 1 millimeter, but like 2 slots down from 1.25, so I think if I take 1.2 millimeters from, so I think if I go 1.2 millimeters below this diameter, then it's like probably 0.1 millimeters too deep, which is like pretty good for this solution. So let's do that. Yep, so let's put 1.2 there. And here we go, this is the last cut. I put little bit more oil to get better. Yep, and now I drive this away. It's important not to get this loose before you are completely sure that the thread is ready, because it's really hard to line up again if you lose the correct position. And if the thread looks like these top of the waves are sharp, then you know that you have taken enough material. There is like, you could use like micrometer with some special heads to measure it. But because we don't know what is the right like depth for the thread, we have to just eyeball it. And I think it's look pretty good. So let's go with this. This part is now ready. And then we are going to just make the other side also. And making the thread inside of the pipe, it's completely the same thing than on the outside. You just don't see what you are doing. And when the thread is ready, it's good to test with the screw that it's okay. And it was. And then we are going to make the sharp thing on end of the meter. And this is going to be also attached with the similar thread that is used on the middle of the thing. But because it's just the same process that you already saw, I didn't film that. But yeah, I think it's pretty good solution. Yep, so it's almost ready. Just this tip from here is missing. And I have it now on the milling machine. It's almost ready. I just have to machine these sides from here. It's just like after sawdown, so it isn't like cool. Yeah, pretty nice. I think I'm going to polish this little bit more because it's not like smooth as this. What do you think?
Yep.
Yep. So one more thing. Now this is nice and shiny and I have to put it here. So yes, pack here.
Yeah, we made it. Woo.
Yeah. So, and we made this for like showpiece for the meter company that they can like show on fair and stuff like that, and maybe do some stupid cooking videos with this, because this actually works. Because the tip comes loose, like this. This why I made this like this. You can screw this out. Hold this on. I don't want to drop this because it's. I'm not sure if it's like too sharp. Yep. And here is hole. And you can put this in. And then there is second hole where is screw that you tighten and then it stays inside. So now when you put this back, this big meter actually works. So it's quite clever. Then I put this back. They say that they are going to grill like whole pig and then they are going to stick this there. I'm not sure can they hold this there for a long time because the 3D printer plastic starts to get soft quite fast. But I think they like this for a while. And then because this is quite long, and I think they want to transport this with plane. It also is in two pieces from the middle. I'm going to open this. I maybe did a little bit too long threads here.
Maybe.
But now it's like fits in your like case. And I think you cannot take this into like cabin with you because when this is like long, I think you can like impale people with this. So it might be not good idea to take this as your hand luggage. Yep. So here it is. And and we have three of these that we are going to give away for you. So I think we are going to pick three viewers that leave comment.
Yeah.
And those lucky three get one of these. Not yep. The big ones. The small ones. So if you don't have anything else to say, please leave a comment what would you cook with this.
Yeah.
So then you have chance to win. And if you don't have luck and in this, you can buy these from Amazon, their own web store, or if you live in Finland, then the Votonet stores have those.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we have now 2 hours time to left ship this, because it has to be tomorrow in England.
Yeah.
They have fair coming where they want this. So I think we are going to now package it and send it away. Yeah, but that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.